good morning. Welcome to Cup of Faith back in the closet. Listen, I am super excited to have all of you here with me today. Yes, I got up this morning and the Lord said, I want you to go back into that closet. So I'm back in the closet, y'all. So the closet looked a little rough, but I'm back in the closet this morning. Listen to me. God is an awesome God. I want you to tag. I want you to share. I want you to post. As a matter of fact, I want 20 of you to start a watch party right now. Come on, you got 60 seconds to start a watch party right now. It is November. 2020 has been a hectic, a chaotic year, but we've still been blessed because we are surviving. Oh my God, we have survived this year. And so many people have passed this year. So many famous people, so many local people. Oh my God. But we pray for the families of all of you who have lost someone this year. We are continuing to pray for your strength. We know that God will continue to see you through. And as you share, yes, of course, we are back in the closet. And the Lord said to me, I don't know about you, but the Lord said to me, he said, your closet is your war room. And I believe that we are in the war room this morning. We are in the war room this morning. He said to me, your closet is the war room. And I want to thank all of you this morning, all of you who have been tuning into Back in the Closet. You've been tuning into Cup of Faith. Listen to me. God is good. God is good. And I want to publicly stand strong. I want to say this on a solid foundation. When your foundation is Jesus Christ, when your foundation is the Lord, when you are holy and you are set aside, you are not afraid of the persecution nor the critics. You're not afraid of that. God is going to see us through. I want you to wrap your Bible. You all know I got to lay the foundation, but I see, listen, this morning I see more hearts than I normally see. So I guess you guys are excited that I'm back in this closet this morning. God is good. Hey now. So I want to read this and I'm going to go straight into this. I'm going straight into this, y'all. I'm going straight into this. God is good. He said that this month, 11th month, is the month of change. And I believe God is about to change some things. But I got to set the record straight this morning before God could begin to change some things. Let me read this. Esther 4. I don't think I put it up. So can someone put it up for me? Esther chapter 4. I'm going to be in Esther chapter 4. And I'm going to read a couple of verses out of there. And then I'm going to run hot. Okay, y'all ain't going to say nothing. Then I'm going to run hot. Okay. All right, so Matthew 6:6 is where I want to start from today. I just got to put this basis down. Matthew 6:6 says, but you, when you pray, go into your closet. And when you have shut the door, pray to your Father who is in the secret place. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly. So the Bible says in Matthew 6:6 that when we pray, we ought to go into the closet. So the problem is, a lot of people have a problem with my closet because they can't show you their closet. But I want you to be able to show you. Listen, in this season, we are preachers. We are children of God. We don't claim to have perfection. We are not a perfect people. We actually say that we come from a background where we have sinned and come short of the glory. So if you are looking for perfect preachers, there are none. If you are looking for perfect people, there are none. We all fall short. So if you're super, super duper spiritual and you're looking in my closet and you're saying, why is she in the closet again? Well, that's something you have to take up with God. But the reason you are watching is because I'm in my closet. One thing I can tell you, God is creative and he is strategic. Everyone, God says, go to the highways and the byways. He put one man in the whale's belly. Listen to me. Wherever God puts you, you preach the word of God. And don't worry about what the critics have to say. Let's go now. Let's go. So I'm going to read this and I'm going to run hard. So somebody put Matthew 6:6 up there for me, please. And then someone else, thank you so much, Madeline. I appreciate you. So I'm going to be reading from Esther 4 and I want to set the foundation so I could run hard. Okay, y'all ain't going to say nothing so I could run hard up in here. All right, Esther 4 says this. I'm going to just skip through. So I'm going to start from 1 to 2. And it says, when Mordecai learned all that had happened, he tore his clothes and put on sackcloth and ashes. And went out into the midst of the city. He cried out with a loud and bitter cry. He went as far as in front of the king's gate, for no one might enter the king's gate clothed with sackcloth. 4. So Esther's maids and Eunuchs came and told her, and the queen was deeply distressed. Then she sent garments of clothes to Mordecai, and Mordecai did not accept them. She sent clothes because Mordecai didn't rip his clothes. So he said, listen, she said, listen, y'all please, she tell a maid, y'all please carry clothes to my uncle. Please carry clothes to Mordecai. And Mordecai said, I don't want Esther clothes. Esther, I don't want your clothes. So, okay, verse 7. And Mordecai told him all that had happened. Now, she sent the maid. She sent Hatash, which was the man who was assigned to Esther by the king. So she sent him, and she said, listen, Mordecai don't want to take the clothes. I need you to go talk to Mordecai. So Mordecai told Hatash what was going on and why he was in front of the king's gate. All right, 9. So Hatash returned and told Esther the words of Mordecai. Then Esther spoke to Hatash and gave him a command for Mordecai. Mordecai said, listen, you're going to need to go and talk to the king. That's your husband. You need to go and talk to the king. And Mordecai told, and then he came back and he told Esther. And Esther now sends another message to Mordecai. I said, I can't go talk to the king because the king is in the courts. And the only way I could go in the courts if I'm called. She said, Mordecai, you know. Now she ain't gone. She sent a message to Mordecai. She said, now Mordecai, you know, if I go in that court or anybody go in that court who is not called, that is automatic death. That's a death sentence you've given me, Mordecai. I cannot do that. So Mordecai says to the servant, Hatash, since you said Hatash, and you're supposed to be a Jew. Now, keep in mind now, Esther was a Jew. They changed her name from Hadassah to Esther to cover up that she was a Jew. Because if she'd gone in as Hadassah, they would know automatically she's a Jew by her name. So now Mordecai is the one who pushed her to be queen. Now she's queen. And now Mordecai have a problem. He's in front of the gate crying, tearing off his clothes. She sends the maid to him and say, okay, tell him put that on and leave. So he said, I ain't doing that. So she sent her right hand now to Mordecai. And Mordecai tell him the whole story. So he comes back and Esther says, I can't talk to my husband for you. Not right now, because that's against the law. And Mordecai sends a message back to Esther. And he says, you tell Esther this. If we go down, she going down too. Mordecai said to Hatash, tell Esther, if we go down, she going down with us. Because just how I am a Jew, she is a Jew. Now let me get to the nitty gritty this morning. Mordecai had to expose who Esther was. And when he exposed who Esther was, Esther changed her mind. And she said, okay, if I perish, let me perish. Because whether you go or not, chances are you're going to die anyhow. It don't matter because you just like me. So the same thing, you out there, you, I am out here and I fighting for the Jews. You are queen. You sitting up on your throne doing nothing, acting like God put you there to just have, this ain't no beauty pageant, Esther. You need to get off your throne and you better fight for me. You better fight for us, because if you don't fight for us, you will have a problem. Now let's go straight in. We're going into plank this morning. This is what I came in the closet to say this morning. Why are we fighting against what we love and admire? Why are we fighting against the things we love? Let's say I going hard in the plank. Listen to me. This is the problem with the church. How is it? Let me go to the family first. How is it? You feel, listen, we have generational hatred going on. There's a lot of generational hatred. You know, people today don't even know you, and they hate you because of who your family was. Not knowing that their ancestors, their grand aunts, their grand uncles, their granddads, their grandmothers, trained them to hate certain family members. And that trickled down from generation to generation. So now you got a bunch of hatred going on. You think now if someone was trained to hate your family, you think now you're going to be jelly with one of them. You think now, oh, you jelly, so now you're going to turn with them on your cousins, on your aunties, on your uncles. Let me tell you something. When you go against your family, you go against yourself. Because ain't no way you think, how could you jail with the family's enemy and expect to be blessed? Come on, somebody. How does that work? Mentally explain to me. this your family, but you sit down with strangers and you talk about your family. I need to let you know something today. If they perish, you perish too. You got to understand, you all come out of the same bloodline. You all need to learn to push each other and stop pulling down each other. Why everything gotta be tear it down, root it up, root it up? You got to understand, you got to remember where you came from. We all toted water together. We all had it hard. We had to take hand-me-down clothes. All of a sudden now, God bless you. You think you arrived, so you think you could look down on other people. It don't work like that. If you are in a predicament that puts you back where you used to be, those people are going to leave you. And the same family you have your nose turned up on are going to be the same family members you're going to need. Let me tell you, Christian people, Christian church, y'all need to get your act together. How is it all of us grew up in the same house, playing dollhouse, all of us were shooting marbles together, all of us, and all of a sudden now we're too grown to speak to each other? All of a sudden now we're too grown to acknowledge each other? Family will always be family. You gotta get it together. What you jealous of? Why are you jealous of me? What you jealous of? What is there to be jealous of? If I go down, you go down. You got to understand, oh my God, there is a tie to the name. You got to sometimes think about the name you carry. You're trying to tear down them, but they carry your same name. Why are we tearing down each other? Hold on, I got to, listen, we ain't going to be in here long. We even ain't going to be in here long today. Why are you tearing down what it is that you should compliment? Why are you tearing down what it is you should compliment? Listen here, I ain't putting myself on no pedestal, but I gotta say this, because Mordecai had to check Esther and let Esther know, you better remember who you are, you know. You better think about who you are. How is it you have female preachers trying to tear down Quinty Sears? How can you tear down Quinty Sears? You never used to look like that. What you should do is compliment Quinty Sears and say, thank you, Quinty Sears. Sometimes I look at some of y'all picture, I don't know if it's me or y'all. I don't know if it's me or y'all. Because y'all look just like me. Y'all go walking cat, when y'all walking catwalk, y'all don't answer what size you have in my, what you have in my size. Y'all say, I want the same outfit Quinty Sears have on. But you are the same one. You go to my fashion designer, you go to my hairstylist, y'all the same preachers. But you tear me down. Come on, man. How could you try to hide? Why are you on my Facebook secretly looking at my stuff, but then trying to tear me down? You better back up with that witchcraft. You better back up. Y'all got to learn to compliment. Learn to listen. Learn to compliment someone. It's okay to tell someone you look good. It's okay to tell someone you smell good. It's okay. It's not gonna kill you. It's okay to ask someone where you get it from, because I want one too. It's okay. But see, it's how you all do things. So when you come for me, they're coming for you too. I want you to know that. Listen to me. You look like me. Y'all got my belts. Y'all got my dresses. Y'all got my hairstyle. I can't do nothing around here, because everything I do, y'all do. But my thing is, I don't have a problem with that, because I love to be a trendsetter. But my thing is, at the same time of setting a trend, you can't pull me down. How you could pull me down? Listen, I on this live. I mean, I could barely see. My eyes hurting. I can't even wear my glasses. See all these glasses I got? Listen, I can't even wear my glasses no more, because all y'all get, everybody wearing glasses. Listen, I wear glasses because I could barely see. My eyes are aging, but all y'all got on glasses every time I see y'all online. I wear glasses because my eyes are not good. I could barely see. It's straining my eyes. I don't want you to be like me. I want you to be like you. Listen to me. If you don't know what I went through to get where I am, listen, be your original self. People will love you as long as you are you. Listen to me. You beat me down. You beat me down. Unless you try. You try to beat me down for going to the closet, but y'all all about in your closet. Y'all all above in your closet. The only reason we don't know it's a closet, because you only got two dress. And the two dress stays right out. You got to bring it together, put two flowers on the side of it, make it. realize. I see some of y'all in your cars. Come out your cars. You are not Jamila Gooden. Get out your cars. You ain't no car chronicles. You gonna need to be yourself, sis. You gonna need to be your, you gonna, listen. God gave every man his own anointing. His own grace. When God said go in the closet, it was not for attention. I didn't even want to go in the closet. Y'all understand what I'm saying? When God set me in here, and I don't know how to explain, I just showing. But when God set me in here, I didn't know it was going to get all y'all attention. Watch this. How many of you see preachers on Facebook over and over again and you stroll past? But because you see the closet, you stop. God is a creative God. He knows how to get your attention. And I came to tell you, you need to stop pulling down each other. Listen to me. How could you work on a job? You work on a job and you're going to tell the customers don't support the business. If you tell the customers don't support the business, don't you know eventually the business is going to close down and you can't pay your rent? See, you got to understand, you're causing everyone to hurt, including yourself. Including yourself. If you work to a company, promote the company. That's the best thing you can do. Why do y'all do that? If you leave a church and just walk away, why the pastor and the members got to be a problem? No, sis, the pastors and the members ain't a problem. You just didn't want to live holy. You wanted to slack up and shack up and do whatever you're doing. So at the end of the day, keep it moving. Keep it moving, because that ain't God. The church is not a gang. It is not the mafia. I don't know why you all treat the church like the mob. When someone leave, oh, we ain't talking to them. No, you, what you doing? God is love. He is a loving God. He said, the Bible says, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. You have to understand, there is nothing more powerful than love. And when you could actually love somebody, listen to me. If you watch it, if you're in a relationship and you talk about your husband's weakness to other people, you're not only bringing down your husband, you're bringing down yourself. Because watch us, the problem is some of y'all don't know how to hold your mouth. Every time you and your spouse have a problem, you go there and talk it. You got to know how to hold your mouth. Hold your mouth. Because that same person in a couple weeks from now may be the one in a position that could help you and your family. But because you didn't talk your business now, they're judging you and your family and you can't get blessed. What you saying to me this morning? I'm trying to say, stop beating one another down. Because just how your spouse makes mistakes, you make mistakes too. It may not be the same mistakes, but you gotta be careful how you're beating people down. Read into that. Y'all, listen, y'all gotta stop it. Let me say this. I talk about everything. I all over the place this morning. Listen to me. You preachers, I don't want you knock me because you see the viewers have. The only reason you're mad because your members aren't here. Your members can't come to this church. This the closet. Your members ain't you're coming here. So stop knocking it. They only, listen, being on live ain't gonna kill you. Because when this lift and they are able to fully go to church, you can be able to continue to brainwash them. You could continue to brainwash how you was doing. That's why you, I don't know, you can't control humans. You can't. You're not because your members watch somebody else live means they don't love you, means they don't respect you, means they gonna leave your church. They ain't gonna leave your church. What are you threatened by? What are you threatened by? You got to learn to support. Learn to support. And I want to encourage every person, whether you white, black, purple, red, wherever you are, you got to learn to be your biggest supporter. Stop waiting on people to support you. Be your biggest supporter. Because the doors they're trying to close for you, trust me, you don't even want them doors. You don't even want them doors. You don't want those doors. So let me tell you what God is getting ready to do in this season. He's about to catapult you. He's about to elevate you. And he said the reason why I had to show you who people really are is so that they know that God don't share his glory with no man. When God does it for you now, no one would be able to say, I had to help them. You didn't help me. So I want to tell all of you who think and act like you're better than people, bring that down. Bring that down. Stop talking with your family members. If you don't have nothing good to say, then shut up. And sis and bro, let me tell you something. You're keeping company with people who talking and pulling down their family members. That's their family. That's their blood. If they could talk about their family like that, what you think they gonna do you. Oh my God. You know, they have this mind going around, you could kill. From you could be on your live in your church talking with me, but then put on the same glasses I have on your live, you could kill. You could kill. From you could talk about how I too dress up, but you all dress up. What you need to do is write a letter and say thank you. You should say thank you. You need to buy me a Christmas gift. You look good. And I compliment you. You look so good. You look good. Because now you realize preaching the gospel don't mean you have to be one down. It don't mean you have to be shabby. It don't mean you have to look like you nobody owns you. Now you know that. So now start beating down the thing you looking up to. Just ask somebody, how do you do it? And you got to understand this. Let me tell you something. God will not use who you want God to use. He uses who he needs to use. Now let's go. I about to close. I got to say this. Oh my God. I have to say this. I ain't gonna lie. People right now are hurting. And I ain't gonna say this and I leave it. People right now are hurting. Listen to me, pastors, prophets, all of y'all, listen to me. People hurting. Y'all have faithful tithe payers, can't pay their rent. Y'all have faithful tithe payers who've been giving y'all, getting y'all clothes ironed. They've been bringing you food. You know, you have some great faithful tithe paying members who really going through a serious time right now. And they may not say anything to you because they don't want to be a bother. But this your time right now, this when y'all need to really pray for your congregation. I know Corona is going around and everyone wants to be safe. But listen to me. Y'all gonna need to pick up the phone. Y'all gonna need to see in this pandemic. You should have compiled a list and gotten your members' number. Because some of you, I know y'all got too much members to know all of them personally. But listen, this is the time you should have got your members' number. You should have called and find out how you doing. If your church isn't in a position to help financially, because I know a lot, listen, the church was closed. Some people, y'all had to exhaust your finances to pay the bills, to pay your rent, your mortgage, the light bill, whatever it is. We understand that. But sometimes they only want to call. They only want to call. Why you think they online and they tuning into the online preachers? Why you think they sewing into the online preachers? You know why you worrying about tithes? Because you don't check for the people. If you love your members, they gonna love you. But right now, y'all need to be focusing on your members. Y'all need to focus on your members. Find out what's going on with your members. Pick up the phone. How you doing, sis? How you doing, bro? Man, you know that I'm praying for you. I just want you to hold it together. From this pandemic started, some of y'all even reach out to your members yet. But open church and want them show up. What they showing up to? Because I want someone who will love me. I just want to know. Listen, you don't got to call me every week and every month, you know. But just pick up the phone one time of this pandemic and say, how you doing? Get a list. Even if you just send a broadcast, we wouldn't mind. But listen, we need to know you care. We need to know you care. You won't give no grocery to your members. You won't call to see how you can help. I understand that. But check on them. They have children. Man, what we could do. And use your pull. Go to social service. Go to Red Cross. Go to all these different places. Listen, I can't help my members, but I got a list of members. How can y'all help them for me? That's what y'all should have been doing. No, let me hit this. Y'all too busy trying to be supernatural up in politics. Y'all need to leave Joe Biden business and Donald Trump business alone. I predicted that this one would win. And I never see no more Facebook foolishness with your one prophecy you won't win. Go sit down. You then talk about it in secret. And when the results come, all of a sudden you are Facebook. I knew it was going to happen. You didn't know nothing. Go sit yourself down trying to get one word. The devil is a liar. You didn't see nothing. Stop your foolishness. Because if you saw it, you would have said it publicly. And because you were saying, go sit down. You try to be popular on Facebook talking about Joe Biden and Donald Trump. Sit down. Go call your members. Find out how your members doing. Get yourself off media. Doing foolishness. Listen to me. At the end of the day, this is what it is. Listen, God was with Donald Trump. Yes, of course, we all know that. But the man arrogant. The man arrogant. God appointed Saul. And when Saul got arrogant, God moved him. And I ain't saying that God gonna move Donald Trump. And I ain't saying that God gonna put Joe Joe Biden there. I ain't saying nothing. What I'm saying is leave that to God. But there are some hurting people. You, even in the United States, you in the Bahamas, you better focus on what, instead you go pray for minutes. Instead you go pray for, what's the other guy name? Oh, Lord. Instead you go pray for minutes. Instead you go pray for Brave Davis. That's who you all need to pray for. You all weren't with the wrong kids. Get yourself in order. Get your house in order. I love you all, but you all got to get it together. Listen, Mordecai, tell Esther, remember who you are. You all need to remember who you are. Stop pulling down each other. Love covers a multitude of sin. You ain't going to be no better than you are trying to destroy someone else. Trying to destroy someone else. One day it can catch up with you. Or it's going to catch up with your children. One day it can catch up with you all. I'm telling you, it isn't always how it looks. Today is Saturday. You know what some of y'all need to do? Who are in the Nassau? I think Nassau's still on a weekend lockdown. I'm not sure. But listen to me. What y'all need to do today, pick up the phone. Call someone. Man, listen, I ain't talked to you cousin a long time. I love you. See, the problem is, I know you going through what you're going through, you know, and I know you're going through a hard time. But there are really some people who's be there for you. They be there for y'all. And you know how they gonna feel when it's over? You only call me when you need me. But you know, that ain't necessarily true because we understand a lot of depression, but a lot of anxiety. I understand that. But will they understand that? Pick up the phone. I don't care how depressed you are. No matter how much anxiety you have, pick up the phone and say, cuz, how you doing? I just want to hear you today. I just want to show you some love today, man. You're doing a good job. Learn to compliment people. You ain't gonna die if you compliment someone. Stop pulling each other down. This ain't no time to be negative. Watch this. The time you take talking, people dying. I gave a word this year. I said in the beginning of the year, through the first 6 months, a lot of famous people can die. That's the word I gave. God gave me that word January 5th, 19th, and 25th, and I shared it. I said a lot of famous people can die. You all see it? A lot of you know the word was God gave me October. He said a lot. He gave me in October to share publicly, but I shared in the beginning of the year. I said the end, towards the end of the year, a lot of local people can die, and we ain't gonna be expecting it because they ain't gonna be sick or nothing. They just gonna drop down dead. Listen to me. This November, December year, these are 2 months God spoke about, and God said a lot of people ain't gonna survive. Y'all see it, right? As much as y'all could say y'all don't believe in prophets, as much as anybody could say they don't want to hear prophecy, that Clara's thing. You can't even run from that. You can't, all you can say is, I don't know how she know, but you sit right there, so I'll go on. Listen to me, November, December, you could take your time and you could talk with whoever you want to talk with, but I can tell you something. You ain't know if you gonna make it out this year. I told plenty of people, 2020 is a year of survival. This ain't to worry about no house and no car, nobody business. Because guess what? Some of you who talking with people, by next week, Saturday, you'll be in the grave. Get yourself together. I ain't got time to be pulling down no one. I got more trouble than anyone else I know. I got my own trouble. I got my own business to sort out. I ain't got time for that. Every man, the Bible says, every man got to work out their own soul salvation. Listen, you can't take no beam out of nobody's eye. Because you ain't passed through nothing. Y'all got to remember something. Y'all can't talk about people, you know. Y'all got children. Y'all got children. It may not come to haunt you, but it may haunt your children, the things y'all do. Be careful how you pull somebody down. Listen, this is Cup of Faith / Back in the Closet. Make sure you share this morning. I love you. I want y'all to be blessed. This is the month of November. Get ready to receive the blessings and the abundance of God. And I love y'all so much. And I want y'all to know God still loves y'all. God still loves y'all. And guess what? I love y'all and y'all can't do nothing about it. Facebook, my family and friends. Listen, I tell people all the time, I got the best Facebook family and friends. I don't even have to defend myself no more. Listen, they will jump on me. They jump on you and they will eat you alive. And not just on Facebook, because I hear the stories. But listen to me. I love you all back. And I want to thank all of you who have encouraged me, who have been a blessing to me. I mean, some of y'all even gave me prophecy that was so accurate. Thank you so much. All of you who continue to say, Prof, we love you. I thank you. When y'all see, let me tell you what I love. I love when I travel and I go to airports and I go different places and I see y'all and y'all say, hey! And y'all hail. I love that. Some people don't even hail. They be looking at you. Does that look like her? That, I that's her. I wonder if... No, just hail. If you see me, just hail me. I may not see you. I tell you, the eyes ain't good. Everyone wearing glasses, so I see. Let me put mine down. But listen, God is good. I love you guys. Y'all be blessed and support each other. This is the day that the Lord has made. Share this. God is good. This is Cup of Faith. Love you guys so much. If you're in Grand Bahama, Freeport, don't forget to visit Prophetic Kingdom Encounter Ministry Street tomorrow morning at 9:30 a.m. It's going to be lit. God is truly good, and we know that God will show up. Y'all ready?
Give me some love, 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 give me